Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Easter Sunday of the Lord's Resurrection. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. I have risen and I am with you still. Alleluia. You have laid your hand upon me. Alleluia. Too wonderful for me this knowledge. Alleluia. Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we celebrate the great feast of our faith, let us proclaim in our lives that the Lord is truly risen, and that we may live our lives living out the pattern of the cross and resurrection in our day-to-day lives. So let us now give glory to God.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who on this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path of eternity, grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. First reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day, and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by the God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness and sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad.
The right hand of the Lord has struck with power. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. I shall not die but live and declare the works of the Lord.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad.
The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has been done. It is wonderful in our eyes.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad.
Second reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, do you not know that a little yeast leavens all the dough? Clear out the old yeast so that you may become a fresh batch of dough, inasmuch as you are unleavened. For our Paschal Lamb, Christ, has been sacrificed. Therefore, let us celebrate the feast not with the old yeast, the yeast of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Together now, let us offer the sequence. And during this octave of Easter, in lieu of the prayer that we offer before the final blessing, we will recite the sequence at every Mass during the octave of Easter. Together,
Christians, to the Paschal victim,
offer your thankful praise. A lamb the sheep redeems. Christ, who only is sinless, reconcile sinners to the Father. Death and life have contended in that combat spendus. The Prince of Life, who died, reigns immortal. Speak, Mary, declaring what you saw wayfaring, the tomb of Christ, who is living, the glory of Jesus' resurrection. Bright angels attesting, the shroud and napkin resting. Yes, Christ, my hope is arisen, to Galilee he goes before you. Christ indeed from death is risen, our new life obtaining. Have mercy, Victor King, ever reigning. Amen. Alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia. Christ, our Paschal Lamb, has been sacrificed. Let us then feast with joy in the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning, while it was still dark, and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved, and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple who also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed, for they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You know, many commentators would say that the resurrection narrative, especially this first narrative in John, is a very pivotal point, no, in the journey of the early Christian church, the early Christian community, no, and in the journey of salvation also, no. So let's just take a look at three points, no, from today's gospel. Number one is that mood of fear and confusion, no, and generally also, no, prior to the resurrection, also the mood of grief and mourning, no, having coming from the death of Christ on the cross, no, and then the second point that I invite you to reflect on is the transformation of that fear and confusion, that grief and mourning into faith, no, into faith and joy, no. And then the third and last point is that I just like to say something about the very end of today's gospel, about John the Beloved. No, he is the other disciple here, although he does not name himself. It is John the Beloved, and we see that line. He says he saw and he believed, no. And first about fear and confusion, no. We need to reflect, no, here we see that here, no, that the women, when they saw the tomb was empty, no, they were filled with fear and confusion, no, and that was a pivotal moment, because the source of that fear and confusion was the empty tomb, no, and then you realize, no, when they saw the empty tomb, they ran back to the disciples, but it was not yet to proclaim that the Lord is risen, no. But it was to proclaim that the tomb is empty. No? And where did they bring it? They stole the body. So that was the thought that was running into their minds, no, through their minds. No? And at the same time, again, that emotion and that feeling of fear and confusion, what was happening, no? So that was the mood, so to speak, no, during that first Easter morning. And then we realized that this is now the ultimate challenge for us, no, to get out of this comfort zone and to create and to do the paradigm shift. Remember, all throughout the ministry of the Lord, one theme that was constantly being brought back is that we need to make a paradigm shift to understand the message of the Lord. And so now here, the women and the disciples, no, at the start were confronted now by this reality, that the resurrection is the ultimate paradigm shift, that the resurrection is the ultimate challenge for us to get out of our comfort zones, our preconceived notions, no, of what salvation is going to be. So that first point to reflect on, no, how the empty tomb really, in a sense, elicited initially, no, fear and confusion from the disciples, from the community of Christ, no. Then the second point is the transformation, no, of this fear and confusion into faith and hope, no. And of course, we don't read that here in the gospel for today, but in the other resurrection appearances, that particular fear, confusion, grief, and hope is transformed into faith and joy when they encounter the risen Lord, when they realize that the Lord is risen. And for me, that's very, very important for us to see that the movement from fear, confusion, of grief, and from grief and mourning happens with an encounter with the risen Lord. That everything is transformed by our experience, by our encounter with the risen Lord. Here, and this brings us to the third point, no? Here, that encounter, we don't have that actual encounter, no, here in the Gospel of John, in this particular narrative, but we see that at the very end, no? When John the Beloved enters the empty tomb, and that line that says, he saw and he believed. For him, the proof was the empty tomb, no? So here you see even that symbolism of the empty tomb that created fear and confusion, now it becomes a source of faith, a source of joy, realizing that the Lord is risen, no? And John the Beloved gives us that insight, no? That as he entered the empty tomb, for him that was enough proof that the Lord is risen. And today, as we begin, no, our celebration of the season of Easter, really the great season of grace, no, let us also reflect on our own faith, on our own journey of faith, how much our own journey of faith, filled with fear, confusion, anxiety, challenges, and struggles, how much the gift and the grace of the resurrection inviting us to put our faith in the risen Lord. And as we will see, I believe in tomorrow's gospel, no, one of the very first word of the risen Lord is, do not be afraid. And that is the gift of the resurrection. And the gift of the resurrection also is for us to stay in the empty tomb. And like St. John the Beloved, to be able to experience the gift of the risen Lord in that empty tomb. And as the gospel for today says, no, he saw and he believed. Siguro mahalaga na makita natin ngayon na itong kwento ng muling pagkabuhay ng Panginoon, ito ang kwento na nagbibigay ng talagang ng lubos na pagpapanibago sa ating pananampalataya, sa ating paglalakbay sa ating pananampalataya. Itong puntong ito ang nagbibigay ng bagong pananaw sa buhay, no? Kaya makita natin, 'di ba, sa simula, at ito'y makikita natin na yung mga babae na gulumihanan sila, natakot sila at nalito sila, no, nagulumihanan sila, no. Kagaya ng mahal na Biren, 'di ba, sa incarnation, 'di ba? Hindi niya lubos na maunawaan. At dito rin, ganun din yung mga babaeng dumalaw sa libingan ng Panginoon, ano. Hindi nila naunawaan kung bakit walang laman ang libingan, no. Kaya nga tumakbo sila, pero hindi nila pinoklama na muling nabuhay ang Panginoon, ano. Kundi ano yung pinoklama nila? Sabi nila, wala ang katawan, ninakaw, hindi namin alam kung saan dinala. At yung pangalawang punto ay makikita natin na itong takot, itong pagkalito nila, ito ay magbabago sa isang malalim na pananampalataya. Pananampalataya at kagalakan nung malaman nila, no, na ang Panginoon nga ay muling nabuhay. Bagaman hindi ito nabanggit sa ebanghelyo ngayong araw, sa ibang mga ebanghelyo makikita natin ito, no. Sa kanilang pagkita at sa kanilang muling pagsama sa Panginoon na muling nabuhay, na palitan ang takot at ang pagkalito sa pananampalataya at sa lubos na kagalakan. At yun ang biyaya ng resurrection, yun ang biyaya ng muling pagkabuhay ng Panginoon, na ito ay binabago ang lahat, no, ng negatibo sa ating buhay, at ginagawa itong kagalakan, ginagawa itong higit na malalim na pananampalataya, na ang Diyos na muling nabuhay ay nadaig na lahat ng kasamaan, lahat ng mga hamon sa buhay natin. At bahagi nito ay yung sa katapusan ng Ebanghelyo, no? Merong napakaganda, napakapayak, pero napakalalim na paalala sa atin. Nung pumasok si San Juan sa libingan, ano, na walang laman, the empty tomb, merong linya sa katapos ng Ebanghelyo, sabi, siya ay pumasok at siya nakita niya at siya ay naniwala. Nakita niya at siya ay nanampalataya. Siguro yun yung ating panalangin, no? Na muling mapasigla at mapanibago ng kapistahan ng muling pagkabuhay ng Panginoon ang ating pananampalataya. Na tayo ay higit na malalim ang ating pananalig sa Panginoon na muling nabuhay. And today let us pray, no, that as we begin our Easter season, we may truly believe and rejoice, no, in the gift of the resurrection. So we will now have the renewal of our baptismal promises. My dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with Him in newness of life. And so now for our Lenten observance, now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask, do you renounce Satan?
I do.
And all his works?
I do.
And all his empty show?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body and life everlasting?
I do.
May Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by His grace in Christ, Jesus our Lord, for eternal life.
Amen. Amen.
Oh, I apologize. We will do the prayers of the faithful. My dear brothers and sisters, Christ is the Lord of life, raised up by the Father. In turn, He will raise us up in His power. Let us address our petitions to the Heavenly Father as we pray. Lord, hear our prayer.
May the Church courageously proclaim your Son's victory to a world living in sin, through bearing weapons of love, that we might live and remain in peace, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the ecclesiastical and government leaders die to their personal interests, so that like the Good Shepherd, they may faithfully serve your people through listening and journeying with them, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May all the baptized believers die to their sins and live up to their dignity as children of God, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. We pray especially for the good health of the Holy Father, and we pray also for all his intentions, especially for his prayers for peace. And let us remember also to pray for the coming Synod on Synodality. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Exultant with paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your Church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord. But on this day above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb that has taken away the sins of the world, by dying has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you." Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity and the joy of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us spend a few moments of silence. And let us pray. Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May Almighty God bless us through today's Easter solemnity, and in his compassion, defend us from every assault of sin.
Amen.
May he who restores us to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten endow us with the prize of immortality.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to a close, may we who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal Feast come with Christ's help and exulting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon us and remain with us forever.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Happy Easter po at maraming salamat for joining us. And we will give you the Alekapa totals next week. But thank you very much for joining us all throughout this Holy Week, this Lenten season. And today, let us continue to pray together and to rejoice in the great gift of our faith, the joy of the resurrection. Maraming pong salamat. Have a blessed Easter season in the weeks ahead. Thank you po.
I can't feed 5,000, but I can feed one. I can't walk in water, but I can walk in the shoes of another. I can't turn water into wine, but I can turn a frown into a smile. Sharing what I have in my hands is the miracle that needs to be seen today. Every blessing I receive is a miracle that I can share. This is what I can share. This is my Alay Kapwa.
Alay Kapwa, a flagship program of Caritas Philippines by the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines.